Good morning, this is Mission Control Houston, and welcome to today's International Space Station update. Joining us here in the flight control room in Houston, Texas, the Orbit 2 team right now on console monitoring all of their respective systems for controlling this orbiting laboratory just about 260 miles over the Earth's surface. Right now the station out over the Pacific Ocean heading northeasterly, about to make a pass over North America in just a little while. And the team today inside Mission Control here being led by Flight Director David Korth there in the blue shirt. Joining him at the Capcom position is Anna Fisher, serving as the communication link between all of our controllers here on the ground and the astronauts up in space. And those astronauts are the crew of Expedition 32, a couple of them only on board the station for a few more days. Starting over on the left, we have our three crew members who will be remaining on board to become Expedition 33. All the way on the left there is Japan Aerospace Exploration Astronaut AKIHIKO. And then in the middle, Russian cosmonaut YURI MALENCHENKO. And then NASA astronaut SUNITA who will be taking over command of the International Space Station this Saturday. And then right next to her is another NASA astronaut, Joe Akaba. Next to him is current Expedition 32 Commander GENNADY PADALKA, Russian cosmonaut. And all the way on the right there, our third Russian, SERGEI REVIN. Three on the right there, coming home next Sunday. They've been docked to the International Space Station since May 16th. You can see the split up of the two different Soyuz crews here that are currently comprising Expedition 32. And again, a couple of them only on board for a few more days. Meanwhile, on board the International Space Station today, though, a lot of prep work for the departure of another vehicle. The Japanese HTV cargo vehicle is scheduled to unberth and be released from the International Space Station tomorrow. You can see a couple of our astronauts right now installing some thermal protection over the airlock to that unmanned cargo craft, AKIHIKO there. And he's joined right now by SUNITA Williams. But on board the station, Joe Akaba, a couple of tasks today with that HTV vehicle. He started off his day, though, setting up some air sampling monitors inside of the International Space Station as they continue to monitor the air quality throughout the astronauts' breathing atmosphere. He was also doing some work inside of that HTV vehicle, removing a few of the lighting assemblies inside, and then closing up the hatch alongside of AKIHIKO. He was also installing a common berthing mechanism inside of Notude, or the Harmony module where it's currently docked. He was installing the controller panel assembly, and a little bit later he'll have an unberthing conference with controllers down here on the ground. And meanwhile, SUNITA Williams was continuing some work today with the VO2 Max. It's an ongoing medical research experiment on the station as these astronauts document any changes in their maximum oxygen uptake as they're exposed to microgravity for long periods of time. The astronauts' bodies can undergo a series of changes, so VO2 Max looking to document any of those changes in their oxygen uptake. As you can see just a few seconds ago, she's also been working to help prepare that HTV vehicle for its departure. She was working on the vestibule, disconnecting a few of the power jumpers, and also installing some of these thermal blankets on the hatch to minimize any thermal loads on the station structure. And then a little bit later this afternoon, she'll take some time out of her day to talk with a few reporters on the ground, giving them a more inside look inside to life on board the International Space Station. Our third USOS crew member, AKIHIKO from the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, started his day off setting up some acoustic dosimeters inside of the International Space Station. They'll be monitoring for about 24 hours and looking to monitor different sound loads throughout the station. He's also doing a lot of work today on that HTV vehicle. He'll be closing out, took some video of the interior setup, making sure everything was in place a little bit earlier, and also activating the reentry breakup recorder. This HTV vehicle, once it enters the Earth's atmosphere, will break up upon re-entry, not returning any down mass back to the ground. He was also inside the vehicle removing some smoke detectors and helping SUNITA Williams prepare that vestibule for D-mate, and then closing the hatch with Joe Akaba, and then setting up that controller panel assembly. And he'll be joining Akaba a little bit later with that unberthing conference with our controllers down here on the ground. Meanwhile, our Russian cosmonauts on board continuing for the departure of their Soyuz craft, Commander Padalka doing some crew departure prep as he gets things in order for his descent back down to the Earth's surface in his Soyuz spacecraft this coming Sunday, also storing a few items inside and then setting up some experiment equipment for the immuno experiment, which he was assisting Sergei Revin in today and will be conducting tomorrow, which looks to track any changes in the immune systems of these astronauts during their long-duration space flights. And as mentioned, Sergei Revin was working on that immuno experiment himself today, taking some blood collection samples and then storing them. Some of those will be brought back down on the Soyuz craft, as it does have a limited amount of space for down mass, returning things like experiment samples or vital hardware for testing or things of that nature. So he was doing that immuno experiment and then gathering some more equipment for Soyuz storage. Then our third Russian cosmonaut, Yuri Malenchenko, who will remain on board the station following the departure of the other two Russians, was setting up and testing some proximity communications equipment gear today inside of the Russian segment. It consists of an antenna switch box and also a control panel for the European ATV, or the Automated Transfer Vehicle, another one of these unmanned cargo crafts that's currently docked to the aft end of the Zvezda service module.